So my name is Alisa Thavikulwat, and right now we're at the eye clinic at the National Eye Institute. So macular degeneration is one of the leading causes of blindness in the U.S. today. It's a disease that usually affects people in later ages, and it affects the cells in the back of the eye, which is called the retina. Those cells die, and when they die, we lose our ability to see where those cells are located, so we can't see the things around us. All right, so if you could lean forward and put your chin into the chin rest, you might have to bring up your chair a little bit. So my project is the development of a focal electrooculogram, which is the machine I have here. The long-term goal of this project is that we want to be able to test the function of cells in the back of the eye. These are the cells that are affected in macular degeneration, as well as other blindness-causing diseases. The goal is that one day we will be able to transplant those cells with healthy cells, and we want to test whether those new cells are working in the eye. And we hope that by having patients use this test, we can tell whether or not that transplantation is working. So I grew up in Baltimore, Maryland. My dad was a professor at Towson University. I went to college at the University of Rochester, which is in upstate New York. Then I stayed there for medical school. I didn't know what I wanted to do when I started medical school, but during the summer between my first and my second year, I went to Thailand and I worked with a mobile cataract eye surgery clinic in Thailand. And that's where I saw the devastating results from blindness. I saw patients who couldn't see getting cataract surgery and then being able to see the next day. That was really powerful and really motivating for me and led me to want to go into ophthalmology, which is how I ended up here. Well, I did go into medical school wanting to be a clinician, and I really enjoy working with people. I enjoy working with my mentor and with the subjects, and I find that this project is very rewarding, is that I always have people to work
yeah,
with.
Yeah, you know, you're probably one of the few Americans that...
I think just be curious. Ask questions about nature, about life. One of the draws to me to medicine was that I wanted to know more about the body, and I was very curious about how the body works and how it heals. And I think that's curiosity is the driving factor for a lot of researchers and physicians. And when you're passionate about a question and wanting to answer that question, that just makes you want to go towards that path and follow
so
your dream.
Getting just a low signal to noise?
It's a very stimulating environment to work in. It's very exciting to be at the forefront of the creative aspects of medicine and research.